Yeah, can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, Anvi, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll continue with what we had started. So 3.1 done. Now we'll start for 3.2. So before that, we will do the concepts that are required for 3.2. So 3.2 is all about touching circles.
Theorem of touching circles.
Okay. 1 minute, huh? Just give me a moment. In your schools, have done the proof, theorem of touching circle?
Yeah, theorem, proof, everything.
Okay, so we'll understand the theorem first. First, understand what are touching circles. So touching circles can be defined as follows. If two circles in the same plane intersect with a line in the plane in only one point, that means if two circles, they touch each other at only one point, then they are said to be touching circles. And the line which is passing through that point will be called as a tangent line. Understand this with this figure. Now, there are two types of touching circles. The circles first can touch each other externally, and they'll be called as externally touching circles, something like this. So if you see circle with center R and circle with center S, they touch each other at point T. They touch each other at point T, circle with center R and T. Both of them are touching each other externally. Okay. So they are called as externally touching circle. And if you draw a line passing through the point of intersection, that is, if you draw a line passing through point T, then that line will be called as a tangent line. And that line will be common tangent to both the circles. Second is internally touching circles. So this means if both the circles touch each other internally at only one point, something like this. So if you see circle with center M and circle with center N, both touch each other internally at point T. And if you draw a line passing through point T, then that line will be called as the tangent line. Now, have you understood the concept of touching circle externally and internally touching circle? Yes? Okay. Now, let us do what is the theorem of touching circle. What does this theorem tell you? Understand that, and then we'll do the proof. So this theorem says, if two circles touch each other anyway, internally or externally, either, then their point of contact lies on the line joining their center. Okay, their point of contact lies on the line joining the center. Understand this with the help of this diagram. So we have here two cases of touching circle. They can either touch externally or they can touch internally. The point of contact, also called as point of intersection. So both the circles, either if they are touching externally or they are touching internally, they intersect at point C. So this is point C, externally touching circle. This is point C, internally touching circle. Okay, either one of the case it can be, but we are taking both. But the proof will be for one. So C is the point of contact of the two circles with center A and B. Okay, point of contact means also means point of intersection. That is given. What is the result? That means what you have to prove. You have to prove that this point C, okay, this point C lies on the line touching the centers. Okay, this point C lies on the line touching the centers. So if you join the line of the centers like this, so if you draw a line that is touching the centers, then point C will lie on that line. This is what you have to prove, or this is a result of this theorem. Have you understood? Let's start with the proof. So the first statement of the proof is, let line L be the common tangent passing through C of the two touching circle. Let line L be the common tangent passing through C of the two touching circle. Let line L be the common tangent. So you see, I have drawn the common tangent which is passing through the point of intersection, that is C. Is this clear? First statement. Now, here you have to remember the tangent theorem. Tangent theorem, what it says, radius is perpendicular to the tangent. So line AC is a radius. So, and L is a tangent. So, L is perpendicular to segment AC. Have you understood this? Yeah. Similarly,
just BC. Just give me 1 minute. Yeah.
Okay. So similarly, the radius of the smaller circle will be perpendicular to line L. So L perpendicular to AC, L perpendicular to BC. That same thing will happen if they are internally touching also. So AC perpendicular to L or L perpendicular to AC, L perpendicular to BC. Same thing is happening for both the cases.
Why is C not on the same line of AB?
It is.
The second, so it is. Not wrong.
It is.
Till point C you should have come. No?
For this one you are saying. So it is, no, it is touching A and C. Line A, C, AB is line then.
Why is it not like this?
No. Wait. Point C is this. This is point C. This. Touching. Where both.
Okay.
Where both the circles are touching.
Like how this is C, in the same way that is C. Okay.
Yes. In the same way this is C. So where they touch, that point is C. Okay, so in both the cases, the radius of the circle is perpendicular to the tangent. So AC is perpendicular to line L and BC is perpendicular to line L. Same thing it is, okay? These both are the same thing. AC perpendicular to L and BC perpendicular to L. In both, okay, AC, BC perpendicular to line L. Now, one thing you have to note that through one point, that is through C, only one line perpendicular to L can be drawn. So it is possible to draw only one perpendicular line through line L. So that means these three points, since it is only possible to draw one perpendicular line, these three points A, B, and C should be collinear. What do you mean by collinear?
Lie on the same line.
Yes, lie on the same line. Now, since these three points are collinear, they lie on the same line. You can say that C lies on the segment AB, or C lines, point C lies on the segment touching, or C lies on the line touching the centers. Have you understood this? Go through the entire proof. Also, I want you to write it down.
Yeah.
So if you're not understanding.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, but now
my,
I can't.
My network is really low.
Okay. But I can't see you. So have you closed?
No,
it?
That I have switched off. Oh. My.
Okay.
Just 1 minute.
Yes. So go through the theorem and then write it down. If you're not understanding anything, you can ask.
Yeah. Yeah, done.
Okay, so few important points about touching circles that you have to remember. First, this first point is same as the theorem. It says that the point of contact, that is the point of intersection of two touching circles, it will lie on the line that joins the center. So you just join the line, you just join the centers of the two circles, then the intersection point C will lie on that line. First point. Second point says that if the circles touches each other externally, then distance between their center is equal to the sum of their radii. That means if you want to find distance between their center, so suppose if you see in this figure, circle with center A and B, they touch each other externally. R1 is a radius of the circle with center A, and R2 is a radius of the circle with center B. And if you want to find the distance between them, you just add R1 plus R2. So R1 plus R2 will give you distance between their centers. Similarly, if they are internally touching circles and you want to find out distance between their center, that is distance between AB. So if R1 is the radius of the bigger circle and R2 is the radius of the smaller circle, then to find the distance, you just subtract it, R1 minus R2. So to find distance between their circle, if they are an externally touching circle, you just add the radiuses. If they are internally touching circle, you subtract the bigger radius from the smaller radius. Are these 3 points clear?
Yes.
So I want you to write down this second and the third one. Write down along with the formula and the diagram.
The diagram also, right?
Yes. Yes. So the formula is this, okay? R1 plus R2 for externally, R1 minus R2 for internally. So write it down.
Done.
Okay, so now I think we can start. We have enough of concept knowledge for practice set 3.2. So we'll start with the first sum of practice set 3.2, which is very easy. It says two circles having radius 3.5 centimeters and 4.8 centimeters.
4.8 minus 3.4.
You have to find distance between their center. Okay, how much is it? So it is given both of the circles, they touch each other internally. So distance between the centers will be the radius of the bigger circle minus radius of the smaller circle.
1.3.
Correct. So write down the solution. So distance between the center is 1.3 centimeters. Write it down. You finished writing this?
So I'm drawing a figure and writing the final answer.
Okay.
Done.
Okay. Okay, second and third one. Can you do it for homework? Same thing. You have to just use the formulas. First, in the second one, two circles of radius 5.5, 4.2 touch each other externally. So you have to find distance between.
Yeah, I can do 2 and 3.
Okay, so we'll move on directly to the fourth one. So fourth one, first understand the question. In the given figure, the circles with center P and Q, that is this figure, P and Q, touch each other at R. So they are externally touching circles and they touch each other at point R. That is at this point here. Then there is a line passing through R, which meets the circle at A and B.
I had a class at 7 that is extended to 7:15. So you can take it to 7:15. You were going to take it till 7. Because I had another at 7 today, right now. Not tomorrow, today.
You have a class afterwards? 7 o'clock?
Yeah. And then it went to 7:15.
No, I didn't understand. No. Let me understand.
I had a class like right now in 10 minutes. But then the teacher has only rotated it to 7:50.
Okay. Which one? Which class? What?
Social science.
Okay.
SS.
Okay. So in this figure, circles with center P and center Q touch each other externally at point R. There is a line passing through point R, which touches the smaller circle at point A and the bigger circle at point B. So AB is the line which passes through R. First, what you have to prove that segment AP is parallel to segment PQ. You have to prove.
Alternate angles?
Yes. But first, what you have to prove? You have to prove that the segments are parallel. AP is parallel to PQ. So that is correct. You will be using alternate angle test. So first you see in triangle AP. So first we'll do the first proof. Okay. Second and third we'll do later. In triangle APR. Okay. That is this smaller triangle. AP is congruent to RP. The reason they are the radius of the same circle, AP congruent to RP, this one and this one, radius of the same circle. Now, if you see angle ARP, that is this one, okay, this angle, angle ARP and angle RAP, that is this one. They will be equal to each other. Why? Firstly, they are isosceles. The triangle is isosceles triangle. In isosceles triangle, opposite angles or angles which are opposite to equal sides are equal. Is this clear? Up to here? Okay. Next, you see in this bigger triangle, in triangle BQR. First, the same thing. QR is equal to QB because they are the radius of the same circle. I've written here QR equal to QB. Again, the opposite angles will be equal. That is angle RBQ, that is this one, and angle QRB, that is this one. These two angles will be equal. Same thing, same reason. Angles opposite to equal sides are equal. So you have equation number one, that is this one. And this is equation number two. Fine, one and two. Now from one and two. Oh, before that. Okay, before one and two. angle ARP, that is this angle, and angle ARP, that is this, and BRQ, that is this, they will be equal because they are vertically opposite. And you know, vertically opposite angles are equal. Equation 3, fine. Okay. Now look at equation 1, 2, and 3. From 1, 2, and 3, you see here, ARP is equal to RAP. Okay, ARP is equal to RAP. And here, ARP is equal to BRQ. Okay, so these two are equal here. Right-hand side of equation 1 and left-hand side of equation 2, equation 3 is equal.
I don't understand. That is REP and this is ARP.
Okay, look at equation 1 and equation 3. Equation 1 and look at equation 3. In equation 1, the left-hand side, and in equation 3, the left-hand side is the same. Correct? So the right-hand yes. side also will be equal to each other. So RAP equal to BRQ.
Okay, so why Fine. Not just from 1 and 2? Why 1, 2,
Yes, 3? Yes, yes. First see 1 and 3. This you understood. So RAP equal to BRQ. But now you come to equation 2. What is BRQ equal to? BRQ is equal to RBQ. Understanding? So these two are equal to each other. That is written here. RAP equal to RBQ. Understood? No? Yes?
Understood. Yes, okay. Understood.
Okay. So RAP from 1, 2 and 3, RAP is equal to RBQ. That is this one. RAP is this angle and RBQ, that is this angle. Okay, these two angles are equal. Now, if you remember parallel line test, what parallel line test says, if the transversal intersects two lines and any one pair of alternate angles are equal or alternate interior angle is equal, then the lines are parallel. So by all, you can direct, instead of this entire statement, you can directly write by alternate angle, alternate interior angle test. Okay, this you must have studied in your 9th standard, alternate interior angle test. So alternate interior angle test says, if you have a interior alternate angle, or if you have an alternate angle between the two lines, then the two lines are parallel to each other. So AP parallel to BQ, and hence that thing only we had to prove. So hence proof. Have you understood this last statement? Yes, write it down, go through it and write it down. If you're not understanding anything, ask.
I'll just be back in 1 minute.
Yeah, yeah.
Should I write this down?
Yes, write it down.
Done.
Okay. Okay, I think we'll stop here because it's already 7:03 and it's better, I think, if you also take some break. So what
you can teach till 7:15 because she will be starting at 7:15.
She'll be starting at 7:15. No, it's okay. I think it's better if we stop. You take a break. Otherwise, wo too bahut ho jayega then. Okay, so you practice the theorem. Yes, the theorem, the sum number 2 and 3, and wait. I think
problem set.
No, not problem, sir. Can you try proving triangles are similar? The second part of question 4. You have to prove that two triangles are similar. The SS test, SAS test, that way. You try.
Yeah.
If you can do, it's okay. If you cannot, well, and we'll do it next tomorrow. Okay, tomorrow what time should I take?
Tomorrow I have a class from 3 to 5, and in the morning from 8 to 1. So 8 to 1, 1:30. No, so 3 to 5, and then after 5 I have nothing. So you can take it from 6 to 7 because 7 I have SS. 7:15 because tomorrow also she start at 7:15. So 6 to 7:15. Or you cannot start from 5?
No. No, I cannot. 6 to 7, I'll take. It'll be enough. 6 to 7. And then after that, on my days, Thursday, Friday.
2 days is 3 to 5.
3 to 5 days. Okay. So see you tomorrow.
Yeah. Okay. Bye. Bye.